Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, and we're going to give you a financial analysis on a multi-unit building that sold in November of 2021. We'll break down the financials for you, so getting right into it. What we're going to look at is a property in the West End of Ottawa. It was a 6-unit. It was purpose-built. It had 4 2-bedroom units and 2 1-bedroom units in it. So this building was listed for $1.8 million and it sold for $1,620,000. It was fire retrofit. It had a scheduled rental income of $74,000. And I broke that out, by the way, so the average rent per unit was $1,027. So that is low, and I think you'll see the ramifications of that as we go through this analysis. Again, $1,027 per unit. So that gives us an effective rental income of almost $72,000. The operating expenses, as you can see on the screen, are a little over $22,000. So our total operating expenses are $29,768. The net operating income here is, call it $42,000, and I'm going to keep rounding off some of these numbers. Now, that gives us a cap rate of 2.6%. Kind of an omen of what's to come. Low rents, low cap rate. The operating expense ratio was about 41%. That's kind of middle ground. That's not bad. The gross income multiplier is 23, and the net income multiplier is 39. So before we move on, hold it. The gross multiplier is 23. That's frequently the number that should be the net. So this is giving us more indication of what's going on here. Now, if we use a down payment of 35%, that's $567,000, leaves us with a mortgage of just a little over $1 million. So the monthly payment on that mortgage is just under $5,000 a month, which translates to an annual debt service of $60,000. So we know that our NOI is $42,000 and we've got an EDS of $59,796. That leaves us with a negative cash flow on this building of $17,784 and consequently a negative ROI of 3.14%. So one must assume that the purchaser went in with a much higher down payment than 35%, or they would have had difficulty being able to obtain mortgage financing on this property. So if you enjoy getting these monthly financial breakdowns, click on the subscribe button. We're happy to send them out to you every month. Thank you for watching.